children are with him. A little bit about the artist, which I think we should know before we get into the formal program. Marlon Palmer was born in Costa Rica and in his early childhood moved to Manhattan, actually Brooklyn, New York, with his family. He had some musical talents and pursued those with his music teacher, but soon thereafter, the teacher decided that he had some talents in art and bought him his first brushes and art supplies. He went into the field of art and shortly thereafter became interested in boxing. Boxing and artistry have some similarities. They both use the talents of your hands. There are techniques in boxing that you can like or not like, and there are the artist's work you can like or not like. They also work with canvas. Of course, we think of the one artist, world known, and we still enjoy his art today, who worked on his back. For a boxer, that's not a good position to be in. In fact, when you're on your back, the artwork is done. However, for Marlon, that has not been a problem. Marlon has had 18 professional bouts. He's won 17 of them. Only one loss. He had 12 knockouts in that process, and that loss was to the gold Olympic medalist Mark Breland. He has also taken up the art of kickboxing and has been very successful at that. Personally, I think his future is in the field of art, and we will have a chance to hear from him later on today. This time I'd like to introduce
we dreams are colorless, color the dream forever. For one color is new color, but two colors are colorful painting. Make it real, make it beautiful, make it everlasting.
On May 14th, from 1 p.m. to 8 p.m., the Ricketts Community Center presents Sweet Dreams Forever. Marlon Magic Man Palmer, One Man Art Show, and Richard J. Ricketts dedication.
go, I shall reach beyond your agonies and your defeats. Even what seems like a losing proposition. Today, the proposition is the dream. Sweet dreams forever. Make your dreams a reality. Be the best you can be. But one thing first, believe. If you believe, it can be real. You don't have to be a boxer, an artist. Fulfill your dreams. Even if it looks unrealistic. Forget the nightlife. Forget the drinking. And most of all, forget the drugs. Spend your time building your dreams and not building your sorrows. If you pray, something must happen. It may be 5 weeks, it may be 5 months, but something must happen. Although it may not be when you want it to be, it will happen. I'm going to take you to a place where no man has been before. Beyond time, beyond color, beyond beauty. On August 3rd, 1987, I dream of a place called Paradise Heaven. The dream of dreamers. The year 1762. On my tour, a voice of beauty said, "Color the dream with two colors, for sweet dreams are colorless. For one color is no color, but two colors is a colorful painting. Make it real, make it beautiful, make it everlasting." All your sweet dreams will come true. Many people think this oil painting is a beautiful woman. No, this oil painting is not a beautiful woman, is not a beautiful scene. This oil painting is a beautiful dream. What I'm about to do now is just like magic. I want you to watch me as I unveil this painting.
I invite you to observe the artwork of Mr. Palmer. I believe, as I said, his future is in the artistic field. There are some murals on the other rooms. If you have a chance, please stop by. There's thousands and thousands of hours this young man has spent. Please take the time to look at the artwork and enjoy the efforts of our artist, Mr. Marlon Palmer. Thank you for coming.
Being much of an art expert myself, however, even an inexperienced person like me can see that these paintings here today by Marlon Palmer are really outstanding. It's amazing what the young man has done in probably a short period of time. Spent many of a thousand hours here in all these paintings around the room. It's really amazing just what he did here. And this one of Mr. Dick, that's really outstanding. I knew Mr. Dick and came down here quite often. And that's Mr. Dick right there. Yep.
He's a very talented kid. I've been working with him for the last 10 years. He had put a mirror on the wall and been very proud of him. Glad to have him here. He's very talented. And I hope some people buy some of his prints. We have prints on sale for him if anybody want to buy some of his printings.
He's very instrumental to the community here that we have someone that he did a lot of oil painting here right at the community center. And I think for the future of maybe some people that might be interested in getting into a painting, I think he's very inspirational to them. And I'm proud to be part of this ceremony today, and I wish him much luck in his future.
I think he's a very talented young man. It's just amazing to me that he can combine art, music, and boxing as he's done. It's very, must be very dedicated, but I wouldn't mind having a few of these paintings myself. I will be inquiring about them. I think they're beautiful.
I think it's very nice, and especially the picture of Mr. Ricketts. As a young boy, I grew up in Pottstown, and I attended the, as a matter of fact, I live across the street from the Bethany Center, and I was, and I knew Mr. Dick personally. Mr. Dick is the way I knew him growing up as a child. So, it's a very good likeness of him, and I understand the artist didn't have too much of a picture to work from, and he did quite well with the results of the picture. Okay, and the rest of the pictures are very nice, and they sort of depict.